to the service this morning on this Palm Sunday. First of all, thank you, Nancy, for the gift of music this morning and for your information. That was the slow move from Beethoven's Pathétique Sonata, and it just happens to be one of Bernardine and Lydia's favorite pieces. So Nancy thought that she would play that this morning for them. Opening hymn this morning, all glory, love, and honor, in Voices United, 122. At this time. time. Easter Sunday morning breakfast next Sunday from 8:30 to 9. We hope that you can partake of that. And of course, our next big fundraiser, the Ham and Oyster Supper on Friday, April 20th at 6. And we do have tickets now, so Marion Woods and Kathy have the tickets for that, so you can talk to them about that. And I want to take this opportunity to thank everybody for those who helped with the trivia night and came on trivia night to have a fun night. And in the end, we realized a profit of $1,000. So I can't think of a better way of, a more fun way of winning, making $1,000 than a trivia night. So, and Robert was had some really good questions, some challenging ones, and some eye openers, let me tell you. So thank you all for that. Are there any other announcements at this time?
Yeah, I'm not sure if I got you doing this, but it says Conference United Church Women, Saturday, April 21st. Actually, it's another conference that I Googled on this thing, and it's actually called the Gathering. And so somebody asked me, what is the Gathering? This is where you're going. Okay. And the other thing is, you need to hurry this week because registration needs to be in by March 31st.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So thank you.
Okay, thanks, Marty. I have an announcement to make here on behalf of the Ministry and Personnel Committee. And so it reads as thus. This congregation is grateful to have Pastor R. Hiley as part-time minister of pastoral care in our church beginning the 1st of March. His leadership and flexibility are most welcome during this time of Reverend Larry's mental leave. Pastor Art's experience is an asset to us, and he is also willing to assist us as other needs arise. We are pleased to hear that Reverend Larry continues to become stronger each day. He is looking forward to starting a very gradual return to work plan that best supports his healing as well as the needs of our pastoral church. More details will be shared as they become available. We appreciate the board's leadership as well as the congregation's support, patience, and prayers as we work through this period of change for all. April 1st, next Sunday, marks a very special day, Easter Sunday. On this day, we must also bid goodbye to a dear friend, Reverend Keith Ramshorn. From the very first time he addressed us as my dear ones, we knew that we were receiving the gift of his leadership. On behalf of all of us in the congregation and the choir, I would like to express to you, Reverend Keith, our most sincere appreciation for your leadership of the Sunday morning worship services that you have led us in for almost 8 months. Your exceptional messages have touched our hearts and filled us with God's Spirit. Words cannot express how thankful we are. We extend to you and your dear wife, Lydia, our very best wishes as you again have some time to spend with family, friends, and your Dundas Center United Church family. Please join me in warmly expressing our thank you to Reverend Keith for his inspiring messages and for his friendship to us.
Sunday. when I will really be away from here. I thank you for the privilege, for that is what it has been, mostly a privilege to be among you and to address you as my dear people, for that is who you are. Thank you so much for allowing me into your presence and for being the kind of friends that you have been to me. I have been greatly enriched and blessed during my term here, and it's not quite 8 months, it's approximately 6 months, I think, that I have been here. It does seem longer. I'll remember you forever. God be with you as a congregation, and expect to see me unexpectedly on one Sunday when I am available. I will come and I will be with you again. This is not adieu, it is au revoir, as the French say. In your bulletin, at the head of the bulletin, this Sunday focuses on the irony of the gospel. We live out at once the triumph of the entry into Jerusalem and the tragedy of the crucifixion. So there are two themes side by side today. We begin in joy and we end in despair. The call to worship is printed in the calendar. Let us come together for the litany of the call. Today we begin Holy Week. It is a week when we follow Jesus into Jerusalem as the people wave palm branches. Today we see the kiss of betrayal and hear the sound of 30 pieces of silver. We see him mocked in a purple robe. We follow his lonely walk to Golgotha. As such a violent and fearful week begins, we remember that God's steadfast love endures forever. Let us pray. Merciful God, we come out of our darkness to receive your light. We come out of our sorrow to receive your joy. We come out of our doubts to receive your certainty. We come out of our anxiety to receive your peace. We come out of our sin to receive your forgiveness. Open our hearts that your grace may fill our every need. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. The hymn number 123, Hosanna, loud Hosanna. The word Hosanna means save us now. I want you to focus on the meaning of Hosanna as we sing this hymn. Save us now. verses. Listen. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this: 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately.'" They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. And as they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark and the Liturgy of the Palms. Please be seated. In Psalm 118, which you will find on page 837, we will read parts 1, 3, and 4 responsively.
Intriguing word. It means save us now.
We come to the Lenten Triad Liturgy on this last Sunday of the liturgy, and the focus on Lent 6 is war. Our two readers are ready.
Conflicts in our world cause at least 1,000 deaths per year. We welcome into our midst the one we call the Prince of Peace. Today we celebrate his triumphant entry into the city of Jerusalem.
In a few days he will die as a traitor. His country was occupied by a foreign power, and peace was maintained by military might.
Civil unrest, armed conflict, and unjust use of power are all too common. Conflict plagues our world. It destroys natural resources, but the planet groaning under our excesses. We need to find ways to promote peace among all people. As we extinguish the scandal, we lament the terror and destruction caused by conflict and war.
This is the last time we will extinguish a candle in this season of Lent. Let us join now in our prayer of confession. Let us pray. God of mercy, we long for peace in our own lives and among the nations of the world. We turn to you and confess those places where our resentment and prejudice make us slow to cooperate in efforts for reconciliation and peace. Forgive us, we pray. Giver of life, in the midst of a world of war, we groan with creation. Have mercy upon us. Amen. Or some response comes from the hymn, As the Sun with Longer Journey, at number 111 and verse 2.
Thank you.
in the prophecy of Isaiah, in the 50th chapter, reading verses 4 to 9a. Isaiah is one of the court prophets of Israel, one of the major prophets as opposed to the minor prophets. The major prophets had more words to speak. The minor prophets had fewer words to speak. But the impact of their words were not lost on the people. Today we read from Isaiah's prophecy beginning at verse 4. The Lord has given me the tongue of those who are taught, that I may know how to sustain with a word him that is weary. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to hear as those who are taught. One of the great and powerful things about Jesus is that he was a rabbi, a teacher. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I turned not backward, I gave my back to the smiters. Here in Isaiah, we see a prophecy of Jesus being flogged, beaten, scourged, and smitten. And my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. This doesn't mean necessarily that Jesus was there, but it's a sense of what was going on in the time of Isaiah as they were looking forward to the coming of a Davidic successor. I hid not my face from shame and spitting, for the Lord God helps me. Therefore I have not been confounded. Therefore I have set my face like a flint. Jesus moved unflinchingly to the cross. I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, the Lord God helps me. Who will declare me guilty? A reading from the prophecy of Isaiah. Thanks be to God. A reading responsively from the Psalms, Psalm 31, verses 9 through 16, which you will find on page 758. We will be reading parts 2 and 3.
Thank you.
I said to you, this is an ironic day. There is a certain strangeness about it, because we begin in triumph and we end in despair. Today, in lieu of the sermon, you have the full text of the Gospel, two chapters long, so that you may listen and feel the power of these words. We have chosen speakers to share with you the impact of the Gospel of Mark on a day like today. We will begin with our speakers at the cross and with Christ at the lectern. Listen. It was now 2 days before the Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread, and the chief priests and the scribes were seeking how to arrest him by stealth and kill him, for they said,
"Not during the feast, lest there be a tumult of the people."
And while he was at Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at table, a woman came with an alabaster flask of ointment of pure nard, very costly, and she broke the flask and poured it over his head. But there were some who said to themselves indignantly,
"Why was the ointment thus wasted? For this ointment might have been sold for more than 300 denarii and given to the poor."
And they reproached her. But Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has done a beautiful thing to me. For you always have the poor with you, and wherever you will, you can do good to them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for burial. And truly I say to you, wherever the gospel is preached in the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. And when they heard it, they were glad and promised to give him money. And he sought an opportunity to betray him. And on the first day of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
"Where will you have us go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?"
And he sent two of his disciples and said to them,
"Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him. And wherever he enters, say to the householder, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room? Where am I to eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. There, prepare for us."
And the disciples set out and went into the city and found it as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And when it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they were at table eating, Jesus said,
"Truly, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be sorrowful and say to him one after another,
Is it I?
He said to them,
"It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread in the same dish as me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to the man by whom the Son of God is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born."
And as they were eating, he took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said,
"Take, this is my body."
And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
And when they had sung a hymn, they went to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them,
"You will all fall away, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Even though they all fall away, I will not."
And Jesus said to him,
"Truly, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he said vehemently,
"If I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And they all said the same. And they went to a place which was called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
And he took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be greatly distressed and troubled. And he said to them,
"My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch."
And going a little farther, he fell on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said,
"Abba, Father, all things are possible to thee. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I will, but what thou wilt."
And he came and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter,
"Simon, are you asleep? Could you not watch 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak."
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to answer him. And he came the third time and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
And immediately while he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with him a crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
"The one I shall kiss is the man. Seize him and lead him away under guard."
And when he came, he went up to him at once and said,
"Master."
And he kissed him. And they laid hands on him and seized him. But one of those who stood by drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his ear. And Jesus said to them,
"Have you come out against us as a robber? With swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled."
And they all forsook him and fled. And a young man followed him with nothing but a linen cloth about his body. And they seized him, but he left the linen cloth and ran away naked. And they led Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes were assembled. And Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with the guards and warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council sought testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many bore false witness against him, and their witness did not agree. And some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying,
"We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made with hands.'"
Yet not even so did their testimony agree. And the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus,
"Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?"
But he was silent and made no answer. Again the high priest asked him,
"Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed?"
And Jesus said,
"I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power, and coming with the clouds of heaven."
And the high priest tore his garments and said,
Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?
And they all condemned him as deserving death. And some began to spit on him, and to cover his face, and to strike him, saying to him,
Prophecy.
And the guards received him with blows. And as Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the maids of the high priest came, and seeing Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said,
You also were with the Nazarene Jesus.
But he denied it, saying,
I neither know nor understand what you mean.
And he went out into the gateway, and the maid saw him, and began again to say to the bystanders,
This man is one of them.
But again he denied it. And after a little while, again the bystanders said to Peter,
Certainly you are one of them. For you are a Galilean.
But he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear,
I do not know this man of whom you speak.
And immediately the cock crowed a second time. And Peter remembered how Jesus had said to him, Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times. And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests with the elders and scribes and the whole council held a consultation, and they bound Jesus and led him away and delivered him to Pilate. And Pilate asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
And he answered him,
You have said so.
And the chief priests accused him of many things, and Pilate again asked him,
Have you no answer to me? See how many changes they bring against you.
But Jesus made no further answer, so that Pilate wondered. Now at the feast he used to release for them one prisoner for whom they asked. And among the rebels in prison who had committed murder in the insurrection, there was a man called Barabbas. And the crowd came up and began to ask Pilate to do as he was wont to do for them. And he answered them,
Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?
For he perceived that it was out of envy that the chief priests had delivered him up. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release for them Barabbas instead. And Pilate again said to them,
Then what shall I do with the man whom you call the king of the Jews?
And they cried out again,
Crucify him!
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified, and the soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is the praetorium, and they called together the whole battalion, and they clothed him in a purple cloak, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it on him, and they began to salute him.
Hail, King of the Jews!
And they struck his head with a reed and spat upon him, and they knelt down in homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him, and they led him out to crucify him. And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. And they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mingled with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him, and divided his garments among them, casting lots for them, to decide what each should take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him, and the inscription of the charge against him read, The King of the Jews. And with him they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying,
Aha! You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross.
So also the chief priests mocked him to one another with the scribes, saying,
He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe.
Those who were crucified with him also reviled him. When the sixth hour had come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice,
Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,
which means,
my God, why hast thou forsaken me?
And some of the bystanders, hearing it, said,
Behold, he is calling Elijah.
And one ran, and filling a sponge full of vinegar, put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink, saying,
Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down.
And Jesus uttered a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. And when the centurion who stood facing him saw that he thus breathed his last, he said,
Truly, this man was the Son of God.
There were also women looking on from afar, among whom were Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James the younger and of Joses and Salome, who when he was in Galilee followed him and ministered to him. And also many other women who came up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself looking for the kingdom of God, took courage and went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate wondered if he were already dead, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he was already dead. And when he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. And he bought a linen shroud, and taking him down, wrapped him in the linen shroud, and laid him in a tomb which had been hewn out of the rock. He rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of Joseph saw where he was laid. This is the gospel according to Saint Mark. We thank God for our ears to hear the impact of these words. And as we prepare for Good Friday, let us go forth into the world singing the hymn at number 145, O Sacred Head, 145. Thank you to our readers and to Christ.
Thank you.
God, we have listened intently. We have sought to feel the power of the words that were spoken today. And as we wait for the Good Friday service and ultimately the Easter Sunday service, let us wait in the hope that we will be redeemed and we will be renewed. We thank you for this congregation of believers whom I have had the privilege of working with during these past 6 months. I thank you for the grace that they have filled me with. I thank you for their bodies, their minds, and their hearts, for they have given without question to me all that they are and all that they have. I thank you for these people, O God, and pray that as we move on beyond them, that they will be renewed in gracious spirit. We thank you for the love that has been poured out in this place, and for the ones who will come after to speak your word and to address your people with love. Loving God, we leave them in your care, and we ask that to those who are sick in body and in mind, you will relieve them of their pain and their anxiety, that you will relieve us all of the fears that assail us at this time of our lives. And as we go forth into the world, may we find peace in the very innermost being that we share with you, our soul. Amen. As we present our morning offering, let us present ourselves holy and acceptable to the God who called us to the table. The morning offering will now be received. have received much that we did not earn. The dancing colors of spring, and the early morning music of the birds, the laughter of friends and the love of family. We have received these things as a gift. As abundantly as we have received, let us also give. Amen. You may be seated. A hymn which we will also be singing on Good Friday, Were You There, number 144. Heart, be your love forever. When you go out, may you see the face of Jesus in everyone you meet, and may everyone see the face of Jesus in you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit, our Comforter, be ours this day and evermore. Amen.